Now, the thing about this fallacy, and a lot of these fallacies, is that is if I asked any of you point blank, do you think that the network is 100% reliable all the time? Nobody would say yes. We've all experienced all sorts of hardware issues, security issues, firmware issues that cause connectivity to drop in a production environment. We're aware of all of that cognizantly. But when it comes time to write code, we've probably all written code that looks something like this, where we're newing up some proxy to some remote service, invoking some method on that proxy object, passing it some data, and then getting some response back from it. Who's written code like this before? Yes? Pretty much everybody. Good. So we're aware somewhere in the back of our mind when we're writing that there's lots of magic happening behind the scenes here. That there's the marshaling of this data in invocation into a wire-accessible format, serializing the data, dispatching it to the other side, deserializing, dispatching, invoking the code, getting the response object, serializing the response object, dispatching that across the network. All of that stuff, we know there's a lot of magic that happens here. And again, we're aware that there's a remote call happening here and all of these bad networking issues can hit us. But the reality is we don't really think twice. There's this sort of simple agile mentality of the, well, it works on my machine. Check it in, passes all the unit tests, right? So what's not to like? But the thing is, when we think about compilation and unit tests and all those types of things, usually they're evaluated on a single machine, right? We don't run those type of big heavy tests in a distributed environment. And the thing is, again, even in a distributed environment, this will work most of the time. But that's the issue. It's that except when type of scenario. So what happens if when invoking this code, we get some type of HTTP timeout exception? That's where the problems kind of start. Is, well, we've done an invocation, we have some data, we need to get that data to the server. We sent an invocation, but now we're kind of in this in-between scenario. Because maybe the server is still processing that request, right? This could be some sort of long-running workflow that it's running, and it just timed out. Doesn't mean that the data's gotten lost, but maybe we just didn't get a response. On the flip side, it could be that the timeout occurred on the way to the server, right? Maybe the data didn't even arrive. And if it didn't, well, that's kind of a problem because this is important data and we need to get that to the server. But now, as a client, it isn't entirely clear what we should do, right? We've sent some data to the server. Maybe it has it, maybe it doesn't. So what do we do about these problems? Anybody? What do you do about these problems?
We should have a look at the error code because they're going to get an HTTP error of some sort to help identify what the issue is.
Okay, so if we get an error code that tells us this was a timeout, we're still in that scenario of, well, maybe the server has it, maybe it doesn't. And I mean, we can try various types of solutions. One of the common things that developers do anytime something goes wrong is not always retry, but that is where we're going. Usually something goes wrong, developers log it, right? Something bad happened. Let's write to the log and say that something bad happened. Some of the better solutions are to actually retry it on the server side. Some of the poorer form of solutions is to throw that error in the face of the user and say, hey, something bad happened. You figure it out.
Hi, I'm Udi Dahan. I hope you're enjoying these clips on the fallacies of distributed computing. Click on the left to watch the next video, or on the right to go to the fallacies playlist, or in the middle to subscribe to our channel. For more information, including the full videos from my course, check out the links below the video. Thanks, and see you next time.